It's Fran on the moon. This is my Apollo 11 Super Moon Mania special. All this stuff. This isn't even all the stuff that I have, but it's like the choice stuff. Of course, the most iconic, the Life magazine of the Apollo. But I've also got just everything. I mean, I've got things here, books, videos, laser discs down here. Some of this stuff I've shown, you know, compendiums, paraphernalia, stuff that was issued from NASA, stuff that's been printed very recently. I've even got some real artifacts like my Saturn V launch vehicle digital computer board. Yeah, this is my LVDC board, one of the control boards that actually controlled the Saturn V rocket. I generally don't handle this with my bare hands, but for such a special occasion. Probably the very first video that really got noticed on my channel was the one that I made about this LVDC board, and I spent years analyzing it. I had it x-rayed. It was a huge project, which is archived on my old blog, which I'll link down below. Of course, you can do a YouTube search, but many videos I analyzed the actual devices, and then I got another one of these boards that I took apart and actually did some microscopic examinations of the actual devices themselves and how they were made and the history with IBM and everything. So yeah, well documented, but still one of my most treasured artifacts. And I've even got something here that's actually been on the moon. So this is my actual thing that was on the moon. It's a piece of the Luna 24 spacecraft, landed on the moon in August of 1976. A lot of people think that the Russians didn't actually make it to the moon, but they did in robotic form. They were actually the first to put a rover on the moon, the first man-made object on the moon. And the Luna 24 was the final mission to the moon to actually bring back samples. The Soviets had a couple of successful sample return missions, so they did get moon rocks, and one of them was Luna 24 that picked up samples of soil and returned them in a pod, and parts of the returned spacecraft were sort of sold off. This is during the time when the Soviet Union had just collapsed and they were hungry for money, and they were selling space artifacts right and left. And appears to be a piece of lacquered wiring insulation. Yeah, part of the spacecraft that was on the moon in 1976. So there you go. I'm crazy for the moon. I'm even on the moon right now. So, like I said, this isn't even like everything. I've got stuff in storage that I just haven't been able to find since the last move, but it's in the vault somewhere, even more than this. But it's just, I just love, ever since I was a kid, I mean, I saw the moon landing live on television when I was 3 years old. I've had a lifetime love of all things Apollo and all things space. And I've been collecting space stuff my whole life. This is sort of the Apollo related stuff that I have out here, but I've got stuff from shuttle era, Viking era, Voyager era stuff from NASA, books that astronauts wrote that are not necessarily Apollo related, and also lots of books on rocketry, including, I've got actually got it down there somewhere in the bottom, Von Braun's book, which was one of the first major things that got me into the science of rocketry. A lot of these books I would love to be able to highlight. They're like, especially this, like the compendium of A Man on the Moon. Okay, yeah, and this is the Andrew Chaikin massive compendium, three volumes, A Man on the Moon. It's just, this is If you're going to have any book about Apollo, well, this is three books. It is so marvelously detailed, so many inside photos, of the astronauts doing their training in the desert. It goes back to Gemini, has like escape chutes. It's just, there's just so much in this. It's so thoroughly researched. The photography, there's so many great photographs in these books. If you're going to have a book about Apollo, have three. Have three, the three-volume set. And it's got, it's just loaded with interviews from astronauts, people who worked there, the families of people who were involved in Apollo. It's very wide sweeping. Martin Luther King, there's new stuff that's showing you what's happening at the very same time that we're looking at these Apollo missions, what people are looking at in the news and the terrible things that are happening in Vietnam and the assassinations of Martin Luther King and Bobby Kennedy, all happening in the background of this most amazing journey into space. Yeah. I got to stand on that, the simulator, back in 2014. There's the Eugenia. Oh, yeah. Buzz. So, yes, A Man on the Moon, the definitive collection of books. If you only have one book about Apollo, get these three. This is another great one, Team Moon, How 400,000 People Landed Apollo 11 on the Moon, which is a more recent book by Catherine Thimmish. And this is a light book. It's not very thick, but it's a very direct and great book. I mean, this is a book great for kids because it's got it's a very condensed but very important book about the whole thing. Of course, Walter Cronkite's broadcasts of the moonwalks on CBS, the Saturn V owner's manual, and this was given to me by a viewer in a past viewer mail, and I still treasure this. And also the Virtual Lem, which was a book and a CD-ROM, which you could drop the CD-ROM in the computer and you can go through the whole Lem. This is where they made in 3D files the entire thing. You can get inside the Lem and look at the switches and stuff. Table books like this one. This is the Pictorial History of NASA, which has a lot of huge Apollo photos. Huge coffee table book with just everything. Great stuff. But again, books like this, you'd have to combine the used market, I'm sure. What was really big at the time, too, record albums like this one. There were dozens of records that were out to every news organization, every television station had its own version of the journey to the moon with their specific commentators. Some were better than others, but they would have, a condensation of mission control audio and such mixed in with the journalist of your choice telling you what's going on. Yeah. That lots of Apollo era records back there. Fisher Space Pen. I know people have been trying to get me to review Fisher Space Pen, but this is the more recent Space Pen that I've had. I've had other ones. I had one when I was a kid, but I'm not really a fan of the Space Pen as a pen. It's great that it writes underwater and upside down and in a vacuum and all that stuff, but on Earth, it's kind of a crappy pen. It's just, the ink is thick, and I don't really write with ballpoints anyway. I'm a fountain pen. But, you know, it's as a novelty. Yeah. So, yeah, what else? Oh, yeah, this is a book I've had for a while, The Book of Knowledge, 1970, with Buzz Aldrin on the cover. And it's just one of those things that at the time, everything that you got, you know, in late 69 and 1970, everything that you would get would have something Apollo on it. It was just the biggest thing to happen. So, yeah, and this one on the inside, this isn't about space. This is basically just an encyclopedia of 1970. But it does have Buzz on the cover, and on the inside jacket, the listing of all the manned space flights up to that point, up to 1970. So, but you know, it was just moon mania was everywhere. This is one of those publications that NASA released. This was from Apollo 12, and you could get all kinds of stuff like this, these kinds of pamphlets that NASA would release with photographs. These photographs are not very good. These copies are pretty like third, fourth generation. But these were the kind of things that would be handed out in schools and things like that, you know, printed on magazine stock, that would just be very brief overviews of specific missions. I have other NASA publications that are much more detailed than this, that are not Apollo-related. Satellite missions and stuff such that are extremely detailed, like very thick. lots of books, you know, Lost Moon, Moon Dust. There are a lot of choices. Some are better than others. Some Rocket Man is a little, I guess that there's some criticism for that. But there are like lots of books about Apollo, some better than others. Obviously, the ones that are actually written by people who are there are much better than those that are not. Of course, From the Earth to the Moon, DVD box set, one of the great docudrama versions of what happened on the moon. I love the episode of From the Earth to the Moon about Apollo 12. It's probably my favorite. Either that or Spider about the LEM are my two favorites. And of course, Apollo 13, you know, on Laserdisc, of course. Gotta have it on Laserdisc, you know. This is another must-have DVD, The Mighty Saturn's Extended Collector's Edition. This is from NASA Archives. It's a 3-DVD set. And it's nothing but Saturn launches. It's just, it's pure space NASA porn. It's every Saturn V launch, every Saturn test, Saturn 1B, Saturn V, all the static testing that they did in Huntsville with the testing the F1 engines on the gimbals. And it's just, yeah, it's just that. It's nothing but Saturn V launches and engine ignitions and tests. So yeah, the Mighty Saturns. I don't know if you can still get this, but it's just, yeah, it's 9 hours, 9 hours of Saturn footage. And that's all it is. It's just the Saturns, you know? Yep. It's all of the footage that they shot on the ground. Like before they did the launch, they have all these cameras that are set up shooting every rocket from dozens of angles, and it's all the footage, 9 hours of Saturn. If you manage to find a copy of The Mighty Saturns, you won't be disappointed. And of course, the Apollo 17 Space Archive, I showed this on my video about laser discs, which you can look, which I did a couple, like last month or a couple months ago, where I went through a lot of this. But this is one of those great things that they used to have on Laserdisc, where it was all the photographs and all the film that they shot on the moon, kind of condensed down to you know, one Laserdisc with every single photograph individually indexable with the frame-by-frame mode on the Laserdisc, so yeah. But they made one of these for every mission. This is the only one that I have, yep. I lose the words to really describe my love of Apollo. It's hard to imagine a time of my life that I wasn't thinking about it. And I guess the dream of the Apollo program really shaped my life. I mean, when I was a kid, I was shown so many NASA films in school, actual 16-millimeter films. You know, like every Friday, we would get to see a film, and it would either be like a Bell Labs film or a film about a Gemini mission or an Apollo mission or Skylab or anything like that. So, but yeah, I love the moon. And I guess the Apollo has made me into a lunatic, good and proper. And I just thought you would enjoy seeing a little bit of my mania. All right, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back in the lab after we get through this. I'm really gonna get all I can out of this 50th anniversary week for Apollo 11. So yeah.
Okay, keep the chatter down in this room. Okay, T1, stay no stay, retro. Stay, vital, stay, I stay, control. Stay, welcome, stay, MC, stay, stay, surgeon, stay. Captain, we're stay for T1.